Tony and Corey here, your weekend warriors. We're back on our Trex deck project.
And today we're talking about framing.
The last time we were out here, the old deck had just been removed, and this was all bare, just waiting for this amazing piece of art to be built out here. But that old deck was troublesome. It had a lot of really serious issues that we're gonna remedy with this new deck and this project. In our last video, we had the homeowners out to the par yard, actually, to pick out all of the Trex products that they wanted to use. They chose Transcend decking, the signature railing, the rain escapes, and also the lighting that they're gonna use. They are very excited to see it come together. I'm excited to see it come together. But we need to talk a little bit about what goes on behind the scenes before all that stuff is put on. So what are we gonna talk about here today?
So what we wanna do is, whether you're a homeowner or a contractor, we wanna give you some tips to ensure that you have a successful project. And the first thing we wanna talk about is the ledger. The ledger on the old deck was very insufficient. It was too small, it was nailed onto the house, and there was no flashing to speak of. Oleg with Northwest United Construction built this frame, and he's done a really great job. As you can see, the ledger is screwed onto the house with high strength screws. They're also hot dip galvanized, which is what you want to use with pressure treated lumber. He used a high back Z flashing that will ensure that no moisture gets behind the ledger itself. Mm-hmm. And just in case, as a safety net, he's also installed some drainable house wrap behind the ledger. That way, if any moisture happens to get back there, it will allow it to drain out.
Yeah, he really has done a great job out here. And we actually have a few more tips that we're gonna talk about. The framing that he's already done to prepare for the Trex products that are gonna be used on here.
Yeah, so the homeowners have chosen Trex Signature Rail. Now, whatever rail that you choose or you're installing on your deck, there is a very specific blocking detail that you have to abide by according to Trex or your local jurisdiction. You'll always want to check with them to make sure the blocking detail you're using is correct.
Okay, here's tip number two. When the decking boards come out for this lower deck here, this deck is 16 feet long, and Trex actually makes 12, 16, and 20 foot lengths on their decking. So this will have no butt joints where two pieces of decking come together. That's great for this deck, but that does not always gonna be the situation for everybody out there. And there is a special consideration that needs to be made when you have two pieces of decking coming together at a butt joint. You have to actually take a piece of blocking like this, that's 7.5 inches long, and you have to scab it on or add it to the joist wherever two pieces of decking are coming together at a butt joint. And that's because if you're blind fastening or if you're surface screwing, it's gonna take four fasteners, and you need an extra area to fit four fasteners in where two pieces of decking come together. So that's something to take note of, but that's not gonna be the case on a deck where rain escapes is being used.
Right, because of how rain escapes is installed, rain escapes goes on over the joists, but under the decking. It's a waterproofing system, and we'll do that in a later video, but you have to think about the framing ahead of time because you won't be able to install a block over top of the rain escapes. What you'll want to do is come up with a predetermined pattern that coincides with Trex's length structure, 12, 16, and 20 foot, and do a full length joist from front to back. That way you won't have to worry about installing a block over top of the Trex rain escapes.
That makes perfect sense.
The next thing we want to talk about is blocking and picture framing. This particular deck is going to have picture frames, which means that they're going to use deck boards perpendicular to the other deck boards on the edges. Trex requires 16 inch on center joists. So what you want to do is install your blocking 16 inches on center at the perimeter of your deck.
Here's another great tip when you're talking about the picture framing around the deck. The boards in the field of this deck are going to be put down with universal clips that are not going through the decking, but holding the decking down in grooves along the edges of the deck boards. You won't want to use grooved deck boards for the picture framing because you'll be able to see that groove sticking out. They actually sell for the same price S4S boards with no groove, and that will be what you'll choose for your picture framing. And you know, sometimes it's not a bad idea to choose a contrasting color for your picture frame. Really gives a really nice look to your deck.
I agree, that looks pretty cool.
As you can see, this deck is about 32 inches off of the ground. That's going to require a handrail. And they've actually chosen the handrail that's gonna go on this deck. When it comes to Trex handrail, there's a few different applications for the post. The post could be a sleeved post where the post actually is integral to the deck framing. There is a fascia mount post, which is on the outside of the deck. And then there's a surface mount post, which actually is the post that the homeowner has chosen for this project. They chose Signature Rail from Trex, and the post actually bolts right to the top of the deck surface. That requires that you put reinforcement in the framing so that that post is very strong all the way down and the handrail doesn't wriggle back and forth and seem weak.
To be sure, you can always refer to a Trex railing installation guide. They have blocking details for no matter what railing you choose, but you will want to check with your local jurisdiction to ensure that you're installing the correct amount of blocking. On this particular deck, it was assigned by the engineer on how the blocking detail went together. It does correspond with Trex's installation instructions, but you do want to check. The last tip we want to share with you is going to make your life a lot easier if you're installing Trex lighting. As you can see, this deck is only a couple feet off the ground. So what you'll want to do is pre-drill with a 3/4 inch drill bit holes all the way around the perimeter where you're running the lighting. And you'll want to know where your transformer is. It's a low voltage transformer. So all it does is plug into an exterior outlet.
Knowing where the transformer is will help you determine where your wire is going to start and end. And don't be that guy. Don't wait until the decking surface is down and then invite your best friend over to crawl through the mud and wire all your lights from underneath the deck.
Thank you so much for tuning in. This has been another episode of Your Weekend Warriors.
We'll see you next time.